When moving around the cursor to specify the drag vector endpoint, the tracker shows the drag vector distance and the angle of its direction to the editing plane. The tracker may also be used to input the drag vector starting and endpoints numerically. For example, you may find a vertical edge of a block, and we want to drag to a height of 4,000 millimeters on this edge. To do this, find the edge, then press the Z key to activate the Z field of the tracker. Type 4,000 for value, and press Enter. We can also input coordinates anywhere in space. Let's say we drag our element in the editing plan, then press the Z key to activate the Z field of the tracker. Type 4,000 for value, and press Enter. We may also use guidelines and special snap to help specifying drag vector starting and endpoints on surfaces of elements. For example, we may want to drag to the middle of the right vertical side of the right block. We can draw a diagonal guideline on its surface, then use the half special snap to pin its middle, which will also be the middle of the side. When dragging in the editing plane, the Shift key may be pressed to lock main axes and directions. Using Shift, it's also possible to lock to the direction perpendicular to the editing plane.